Hi guys, this is Sonal from Vermilion. Welcome to Nail It. Today I'm going to be showing you how to take care of your nails in everyday life. So let's get started. First, we're going to start off by removing the old polish using a lint-free cotton wipe and non-acetone polish remover. The right way to remove polish is just use your cotton wipe, press and remove. Don't go to and fro on the nail, just go in one direction. Washing your hands thoroughly will remove off any polish residue that you had on your nails and your hands. Now we're going to use a glass nail file to file your nails down to the length that you need and to the shape that you need. Why I'm using a glass file is because it is gentle for your nails. The most important rule when you file your natural nails is that go in one direction. Never go to and fro, just go in one direction. Nails short or long does not matter. What matters is keeping them in good shape. If you want them square, I would suggest you keep the edges round so you do not hurt yourself or someone else. One more thing you need to remember about nails is it's always better to file them rather than cut them, because cutting your nails will make them weaker. Maybe if you want like a drastic change from your long nails to your short nails, you can cut them, clip them a little bit, but otherwise filing is always better. The next step would be gently buffing your nails, removing any dead skin cells that are left on your nails. And again, don't be too harsh, just be very gentle when you buff. Invest in a nice three-way buffer or a shining buffer to give that natural shine to your nails. The next step would be to use a hydrating base coat. Again, I would say that invest in a nice base coat. Base coat is one of the most important steps in the nail care. You can escape from the dirty yellow stain by using a base coat. So let that base coat dry for at least 15 seconds before you go on to polishing your nails. Now that the base coat is dried, we're going to apply the first coat of polish. It's always better to apply thin coats of polish, even if it takes 4 coats. I'm applying the second coat. Don't worry if the polish gets onto your skin. We can remove it later with a Q-tip. I'm just going to take a Q-tip dipped in the polish remover to remove the polish that's onto the skin. Just wait at least 10 minutes between each coat of polish. And after you apply the second coat, just let it dry completely before you do the top coat. Again, top coat is also a very important thing because it helps your polish last for a long time. And it also gives that amazing shine. The final step in your perfect manicure will be hydrating your dry cuticles. Invest in a nice cuticle oil or a cuticle butter that will help in your natural nail growth as well. People who have problems with nail growth, etc., I would suggest them to use nail hardener or a nail strengthener as a base coat. It's called Sally Hansen Nail Growth Miracle, and this is very hydrating and you can use it as a base coat or as a top coat. Finally, eat fresh fruits and vegetables and drink plenty of water to keep your nails hydrated and keep them beautiful. For more nail care products, drop into Vermilion and keep watching Nail It.